All right, guys, this is a new black trim restoration product slash black trim ceramic coating. I know it feels like those two things can't even go together. It doesn't even make sense, but they do. It's an amazing product. This is gonna be a valuable video. You ought to stick around to the end because this is a sweet new product that I think is kind of revolutionary. So it's called Cerakote Trim Coat. As you guys can see, this is, like I said, a black trim restorer and a black trim protector, black trim ceramic coating. So not only can this be applied to faded black trim in order to restore it and protect it for, according to the packaging, up to 200 washes, it can also be applied to just regular black trim that's not faded, that's new, as a ceramic coating, not just a little preventative protection measure. It's actually something that's gonna last for, again, up to 200 washes. So it's a big claim, but in this video, hopefully you guys can kind of see why that makes sense. Now, many of you guys know solution finish is always what I've been pushing for black trim restoration. It's still an amazing product. I still love it. You know, it's not like I'm not gonna push that anymore, but this is just another one that I'm really glad I got my hands on because it's a difficult thing to find a black trim restorer that works, much less one that actually lasts. And that's actually one of the problems that I've had with solution finish is it works, but generally after about a year, you have to reapply it. And so the question is, maybe can this be something that restores as like icing on the cake and is a really protective, preventative, fading measure to put on black trim. So anyway, let me go ahead and explain and show you guys how this is applied. So real fast before we do anything, check out the black trim before it actually gets restored. You guys can see it's really faded. It's been sitting in the sun. This particular black trim was black trim that I applied solution finish to a little over a year ago, and this is what it looks like a year later. So again, that's not a knock on solution finish or anything like that. That's just the natural, you know, that's like the law of entropy, you know, things just tend towards disorder. Now, guys, when you're applying this Cerakote, you have to prepare the black trim correctly. So I want to explain in detail how I'm doing it in this video. Number one, I'm going ahead and just rinsing the black trim with some water. Secondly, I went ahead and filled up my pressurized pump sprayer with some degreaser and some water, not any particular dilution. It's not really that important. It's probably like 5 to 1. And I went ahead and just sprayed a bunch of degreaser onto the black trim, and I'm scrubbing it with a bug sponge. Why am I scrubbing it with a bug sponge? A bug sponge is just a really aggressive way to clean something because it's got that mesh outer layer, that like exoskeleton on it with the sponge as the interface, and it's an easy thing to manipulate and move around and work with, and it just works really well to clean because, again, it's just particularly aggressive. So I'm just trying to get all the crevices and all that stuff, surface dirt off, and letting the degreaser kind of do its thing. Then simply, I'm gonna take my hose, wash it off, make sure I get all that degreaser off because I don't want anything getting in the way or messing up my black trim product here. And then, and this is the really, 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 really important part, this Cerakote black trim ceramic coating does not work well with water. Make sure that you do not get it in touch with water. Okay, so I'm taking, number one, I'm taking a rag, but I'm also gonna take my leaf blower and spend some serious amount of time. I know I'm speeding this up, but in real time, I spent like at least 5 to 10 minutes blowing it just to make sure every single crack and crevice was totally dry, so that nothing actually drips onto the paint. Now, like I said, the Cerakote package here that I have comes with 10 of these tiny little kind of moist towelette packages, more or less, is what they look like something you'd open after you like wash your hands with after you eat ribs or something. But basically, it's just like this tiny little moist towelette that's folded into fourths, okay? This thing is drenched with solution, okay? So one of these towels goes a really, really, really long way, all right? It's also important to understand that I'm applying this to porous black trim. I would not apply this to black trim that's not porous. I just find that it works best with porous black trim, and not to mention with non-porous black trim, as just a general rule, no matter what kind of black trim says that it can be applied to that, I would just rather use like a mild abrasive polish because that will restore that non-porous black trim really well. And so I just wouldn't bother with a product like this in the first place, or any other product for that matter. So this is porous black trim. It's got that semi-permeable membrane, kind of is a good way to think about it, so that any dye that gets on it is gonna kind of get absorbed, kind of like water gets absorbed into your body through your pores if you're swimming or something like that. Anyway. Point being, there's a ton of this dye, or the product. It's not actually a dye, I keep saying that, but it's not a dye. Again, it's a ceramic coating that also is going to restore that fade. So basically, I'm just taking it, folded into fourths, and applying it. This is one of the best things about this product. I open it, I pull it out of the package, I rub it all over the black trim. I don't have to rub it in one uniform direction. I can do circles, lines, both, anything. It's gonna dry in that uniform appearance, and I don't have to follow up with anything. It's in apply and leave it, okay? I don't have to follow up with the microfiber towel. I don't have to follow up and get rid of the excess. Like solution finish, I have to apply it, then I have to wipe off the excess. I don't have to do that here. I literally apply it in any way that I want to. A monkey could do it, okay? I could do this with both hands tied behind my back with a blindfold. Well, probably not that, but it's super easy to do, okay? That's my point. You guys can see that in this video. Now, with this black trim, it can be kind of tedious, and so there's different ways that I'm manipulating the towel. I'm gonna open it up, fold it over, shove it down in those tiny little cracks and crevices of the textured pieces and design of the black trim itself to make sure that I get everything. But once again, because this product, because there's so much product on the towel itself, it's really easy to work in the cracks and crevices. And this is one of the advantages I would say that this has over solution finish, because I don't have to apply it to like this paintbrush sort of thing and then try to shove it in these cracks and crevices. The towel is really easy to manipulate, so I can just get it in all of these areas really, really simply. Now, I would suggest being careful with getting it on paint. That might be one of the drawbacks a little bit. Solution finish is a bit easier when you get a little excess on the paint. It's not gonna hurt anything. This is not gonna hurt anything either. You can see I didn't tape anything off, but I would just say be careful getting it on paint. I just don't risk things like that. It's just like your risk management. Now, I wanna read you guys the directions here on the back of the Cerakote Trim Coat package that you can see here that I'm applying in this video. It says right here, number one, wash and dry surface thoroughly using a non-wax containing detergent such as Dawn dish soap. In this case, I just use degreaser. Number two, must be applied to a completely dry surface. Don't have any water on the surface. Number three, you may want to open and close doors, trunks, and hoods several times to free any trapped water. Roll down windows to avoid any contact with glass, so don't get it in contact with glass. If product comes in contact with paint or glass, remove immediately with a clean, dry cloth. Number four, wearing provided gloves. It does come with gloves, by the way. Open one pack and wipe trim surface using the pre-wet wipe in overlapping passes to ensure full coverage. Number five, rotate wipe as needed, ensuring you use all the surfaces of the wipe. Move to a new pack when wipe becomes dry or soiled. Number six, after application, allow a minimum of 30 minutes before driving or exposing to moisture. So you definitely have that dwell time of 30 minutes, but that's like no time at all, okay? 30 minutes is like, yeah, it's a joke. Another thing that I'd like to note about this particular application is you can see I'm actually applying it outside in the direct sunlight. Now, I'm not saying you have to apply it in direct sunlight, but I am saying that I'm doing it here. Again, I'm not suggesting you do it. Of course, manufacturer's directions say keep it cool, do not apply in direct sunlight, trim must be cool to the touch, but basically, I'm just showing you guys, I think this speaks to the quality of the product itself in that, yes, the manufacturer says don't do it in the sun, but I did it here in the sun and it's working just fine. Okay? Again, like I said before, the big claim about this product is that it lasts for up to 200 washes. And if that is true, that's gonna be a serious game changer in my opinion for the detailing world. Now, again, I wanna be clear. They are marketing this product as a black trim ceramic coating. I have never seen something like that before or used something like that. So while after this initial application right here, I can't necessarily speak with authority to the durability of the product, I am gonna be doing update videos throughout this year of this particular black trim on this particular car. This is a car that's like 13, 14 years old. No, it's more like 16 years old actually. So this was a perfect, perfect subject for this video because it's just like, man, this product reacted so well with this black trim that if it does this well with this, you know, future newer vehicles, I can only imagine how well it's gonna do with them. But again, 200 washes, in my opinion, is that's a lot longer than just a year, you know what I mean? It's like who washes their car 200 times in a year, you know what I mean? So let's say you wash it once a week, that's only 52 washes a year. So, you know, that would put this product at somewhere lasting maybe between 3 and 4 years, let's say if you're a person who really maintains their car on a regular basis, which again, I can't speak to that with authority, but if that is true, that's gonna be real impressive. And of course, I'm gonna be posting update as far as durability and gloss levels with this particular product. All right, guys, there you go. That is Cerakote Trim Coat. Absolutely an amazing product, and glad I came across it, actually, because generally it's kind of hard, and it's been hard over the years, to find good black trim restoration products on top of products that will actually last and be sort of a preventative and protective measure, not just restore. So Solution Finish is one of those that I really push because I love it for restoration. But this one, I think, even gives that a run for its money. So anyway, if you guys want to check out Cerakote, I'm gonna hook up a link below in the YouTube description box. Definitely check that out. If you're new to the Wilson Auto Detailing community and you love everything auto detailing, then consider subscribing. And as always, from Luke here at Wilson Auto Detailing, keep working hard, and I'll see you guys in the next video.